Thank you for tuning in to today's stunt game here at Artsmith Arena at Alma College. Today's game will feature a doubleheader of the Alma College Scots against Central Michigan University. My name is Peyton. I'm here with Alex. Alex is an alum of Alma College, so I'm happy to have her here with me today. It's nice to have someone else kind of on air. So we're just finishing up pregame stuff. We're waiting for the coin toss. All right, looks like we have the captains and coaches heading over for the coin toss right now.
During the coin toss, what they're doing is they're going over rules with both teams. Usually that comes up with coaches, assistant coaches, either the captains or maybe even seniors. That's usually who comes up into the middle for the coin toss.
Now whoever wins will get to choose if they can, they'll take possession in the first half or they defer to the second half. So let's see what the decision is.
Looked like CMU won the coin toss. CMU has decided to take possession in the first quarter.
All right. And we're going to start with our first quarter of partner stunts. And it looks like CMU chose routine number 3. So with these routines, they go up in difficulty. So 3 is about kind of middle ground there in difficulty. Right, we have both teams starting off pretty strong so far. Everything looks very clean. Alma's first routine on the mat since winning their 2022 national title. Alex, you were on that team.
So that was a really exciting time. It's really exciting to see all the girls back on the mat.
Yeah, in brand new uniforms too. And the point goes to Alma. All right, looks like they're choosing routine number 7 now. And they seem very, very excited about it.
This is the second longest routine in difficulty. This is right behind partner stunt 8.
Looks like CMU is going to come back from that fall and end it pretty strong. And point goes to Alma again. And Central is going to choose routine number one.
On the lower level routines, there's often more partner stunts out on the mat. And then once they get to higher difficulty, there's less. That's why for partner stunts 7 and 8, you're only going to see 2 partner stunts.
Okay. Yeah, this is going to be the most basic level. Yeah, super clean.
In this time where we're waiting, this is where the judges are looking over the routines. They might be counting up minors because the routine was so close.
Okay. Now they can award a team a point to both teams if they choose to do so.
Yep, if both teams have the same amount of minors, or if they have both teams have no minors or no majors, then it can go out into a tie where both teams will receive a point.
All right, looks like we have a decision. And the point goes to Alma. All right, Alma picks routine number 4. See, in this one we have 2 stunt groups. Alma is looking solid today. Right, looks like we have some judges making decisions still. As you can see, Alma's in new uniforms for this game. They got new uniforms for this season. We also have new mats. We'd like to thank Michael Sherman for our new mats this season. This is the same Michael Sherman of the Sherman weight room facility and the cheer and stunt facility. So thank you very much for your generous support. And the point goes to Alma. All right, so after quarter one, Alma currently leads 4-0. We're going to take a quick break and head into quarter two next. We'll be right back. All right, we are back, ready to kick off quarter two, pyramids and tosses. And we're gonna kick this quarter off with routine number one. Had some nice tosses. Looks like we're heading to our first pyramid. And point goes to Alma. All right, and we're gonna do routine number five next. Looks like we'll be starting off with a pyramid in this routine. Like the basket in the back. Nice. A nice pyramid from each team.
Now we're gonna move into tuck baskets.
I love basket tosses.
This routine is a repeat routine of last year, so that means it was also played last year.
You said it's from last year? Okay. Yeah, Central had a little trouble there at the end, but overall they looked pretty good. Alma was solid.
Routine numbers 1, 3, and 5, also 7, are repeats from last year, so that means that they just came from they came over from last year, and then routines 2, 4, 6, and 8. Are different, so they alternate every year. So next year, routines 2, 4, 6, and 8 will be repeat routines.
Okay. And they do that with each quarters, each
yep.
quarter.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably nice you don't have to learn 8 brand new routines every year. All right, and point goes to Alma. Alma is currently 6-0. Looks like we're doing number 3 next.
So this is another repeat routine of last year.
Okay.
I'm gonna start off with kick baskets.
Those are nice. Now with these repeated routines, do we typically see a lot of the same athletes in them, or do they change it up a lot, or does it really depend on the team and the program?
It depends on the program, and also depends on how many seniors you graduate.
Yeah, that's true. All right, Scots win again. All right, we're going with routine number two. All right, while we wait for judge's decision, we'd like to give a shout out and a thank you to our gold sponsors at My Michigan Health, the exclusive healthcare provider of Alma College. Now back when you were an athlete on the stunt team, did you have a quarter that was your favorite?
Yes, I was a shoulder when I was on the team, so pyramids and tosses was always my favorite.
Yeah.
It's just so much fun being out there with as many team members as you can have.
Yeah, that is the one where you see the most people. All right. Point goes to Alma. All right, as we head into halftime, Scott's currently lead 8-0. We're going to take a halftime break, and we will be back after. All right, we are back in the second half. We're going to kick off jump and tumble with routine 7. Here we're just jumping right into it. Alma seems excited, though. They seem ready.
I'm very excited to see what both teams put out on the mat. This is a very hard routine, and it's a brand. Oh, actually, no, this is a really cool routine.
Nice start to our second half there. Well, let's see what the judges think. All right, point goes to Alma. Central has called a timeout. You can stay up to date with the latest news, schedules, scores, recaps, and more by downloading the official mobile app for Alma College Athletics. The app is the Alma Scouts Front Row app. It's in the Apple App Store or Google Play, and you can download it today for free. Again, you can see all information on our Scouts Athletics through there. Next week, our Scots travel to Davenport. They have 2 games against Davenport and Michigan State University. And the following weekend, they face off against Olivet and U of M. And February 25th, we're back at home. We have a big tournament. And that first day, we'll be playing CUAA and Davenport. So stay tuned to support Scots. All right, after the timeout, CMU is going to choose routine number 2. So this is one of the routines this year that is new. It was a beautiful tuck from Carly Scott.
To know the counts, it also helps with knowing what comes next.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, synchronization and timing is one of the biggest things that they're looking for in all those routines. We've had a lot of long pauses waiting for points today, even though the Scots have been given all of them. Oh, and we have our first tie, and Central gets their first point on the board. All right, and Alma gets possession. And Right, we got routine five up next. So routine five is from last year, correct?
Yes.
All right. Both teams look pretty strong in that.
It's a very difficult routine because a lot of skills are to the side, so the stick and stand is really important. You can see any foot movement from either team.
Yeah, it's a lot harder to hide those tiny little bobbles when you're right on the side there. While we wait for the judge's decision, Alma College would also like to thank its silver sponsor, Michigan Community Credit Union, for their generous support. What's it like being back as an alumni for your first year watching this team?
Living in that area, I'm often able to come watch them practice if I want to. And it's all really awesome to see the growth from the beginning of the year till now.
Yeah, definitely.
It's fun to watch from the outside.
It's different, but it's nice probably. Mm-hmm. All right, so Alma got the point in the last one, and here we are now. Those side skills again. Lots of precision. All right, and both teams are awarded a point for this round. All right, we are done with quarter three. We're gonna take a 2-minute break and we'll be back for quarter four, which is the team routine, which will encompass all three rounds that we've watched today so far. We'll be right back. All right, we're gonna kick off quarter four with routine number six. So here they're gonna do the partner stunt, the pyramids, tosses, and then the jump and tumble from routine six.
It actually goes partner stunt, jump and tumble, then pyramid.
They switch the order. Some trouble from each team there. Let's see if we bounce back. All right, nice. Now we're doing jump and tumble. Some nice clean layouts from Alma. And two nice goals from each team. Trouble from Alma there, and it looks like Central has four-footed pyramid in tosses, routine six. All right, still a strong finish for Alma. Now with this round, each team can score up to 3 points. They'll be awarded a point for each individual section.
And with the pyramid and tosses, because CMU forfeited, Alma is playing against the standard. So they have to get a lower amount of majors and minors compared to the standard.
Yeah, so Central will not receive a point for sure, but Alma still has to perform well in order to be awarded that point. Now I saw each routine wasn't perfect there for either team, but that was routine six, so that's very high in difficulty.
There's also a lot of new skills that we haven't really seen in Stunt.
Yeah, I agree. A lot of new things that we haven't seen before. First point goes to Alma. And second point will go to Alma.
And third point, no one was awarded. So Alma receives two, CMU receives zero.
All right, and we're going to do the third routines. So as you said, they perform against the standard in the case of a forfeit, and we did see a pyramid have some trouble, so it makes sense there was no point awarded to anyone there. Nice start from each team. Alma just looks rock solid in these partner stunts.
intern from CMU.
Stick from Alma there.
From both teams.
Yeah, definitely strong. I think with those, you know, routines one through three, they're on the easier side. They're a lot easier to make clean. Probably a lot easier to clean. There's definitely a lot of talent on each of these teams, and it's really cool to watch. All right, and so with routine number one, second point also goes to the Scots. And third points go to the Scots. They swept this routine, and now they get to choose the next one. All right, they're choosing seven. They're amped up and ready to go. So we saw a partner stunt seven earlier. It was a very good routine. Some excited sidelines on each team. Nice hurdler tucks with two folds. A nice basket in the back there by Alma. And a stuck pyramid. Looks like Central didn't quite get up there. We're gonna head into some more tosses. And Scots are right on time. All right, Scots end that one solid. Central has a little trouble.
The second highest difficulty. That was a very nice routine from both sides.
Yeah.
Both of them look like you could see that there's a lot of heart out there.
For sure.
I believe CMU is only in their second year of their stunt program, which is really awesome to see them throwing out these high-level partner stunts and tosses.
Yeah, I agree. Last year was their inaugural year. They've had a cheerleading program for a while now, but it's awesome to see them getting into Stunt the Sport. Point one goes to Alma. Point two goes to Alma as well. And point three goes to the Scots. All right, the Chippewas have chosen routine number one.
This is going to be the last fourth quarter routine played. There's only three routines played in the fourth quarter compared to four in quarters one through three.
A nice clean start from both teams. Nice to see the sidelines so excited and hyping up their teammates. It's very fun to watch.
There's a big crowd here at Alma today.
Yeah. We have a lot of fans here. I agree, that was nice. A strong finish for each team. So this was the last routine of this game, but stay tuned. Today is a doubleheader between the Chippewas and the Scots. So shortly after game one ends, we will be back with game two. It's the first game of the season for the Scots, and I believe it's the first game of the season for the Chippewas as well. Both teams are just getting their season started. And like we said, Alma's currently holding the national title for the Division III Stunt National Championship. The Scots have a strong history in Stunt the Sport. They've qualified for nationals every year since 2014 and currently hold three runner-up titles in the D2, D3 division. And right now they're holding two national championships in the D3 division. This team also has a lot of, and has produced a lot of, All-American athletes. So a lot of good athletes come through this Scots program. And it's very fun to watch. All right, point one goes to Alma. Second point goes to the Scots. And the third point also goes to the Scots.
Scots win 23-2.
All right, well, Alma is victorious in game one. We're gonna come back in 15 minutes for our second game. Stay tuned. All right. Hello, everyone. We are back for game two of the day. Looks like we're heading into the coin toss for this game.
Again, with this coin toss, we see if who wins, and then they may choose to keep possession or they may defer to the third quarter. When they defer to the third quarter, that means that they get to call the first routine that's played after the half. We see our official out there. Her name is Mary. She's actually a alumni of Alma College. She graduated last year and was also part of the... Oh, there was an accident down there. She was also part of the D3 National Championship winning team. And it looks like CMU has possession.
And with this being the second game of the day, we're going to see the same routines again and maybe some new ones that they didn't get to play in the first game. So we're going to start off with routine number three.
We did see this in the last game. I think we saw it twice in the fourth quarter. Okay.
Everyone's looking pretty solid so far. All right, we're starting off this game with a tie. And Alma now chooses to do routine five. Solid from each team. The little bobbles from Central. Point goes to Alma. All right, let's see what CMU chooses. Going number four. Central had a bobble, but they kept it up. And Central fights again. See some good determination in these ladies. And a strong finish from each team now. So with most stunt start seasons starting now, when do they release the choreography for these routines?
Early in the fall, I believe, around September.
Okay.
September, October. they're released.
So they've been mastering and perfecting these routines for a few months now. All right, and that's paid off for Alma because they win this point. We're doing routine number two.
Lots of lower levels. Lower levels.
I wonder if we'll get higher levels when it comes to quarter four. Do a little bit of everything. It was very nice and clean.
That routine ends with a tip up. That can be very challenging at the end of a routine.
Yeah. All right, point goes to Alma. At the end of the first quarter, Alma leads 4-1. We'll have a 2-minute break and return for quarter two, pyramids and tosses. All right, we're going to kick off the second quarter with routine number one, which was chosen by Central Michigan. Starting off really strong from each team here. I like that pyramid a lot. All right, point to Alma. All right, up next is routine six. And Central will forfeit this one. Alma, however, will still perform the routine. And if the judges decide it's too standard, then they'll be awarded a point.
Alma had some trouble with this one in her game one.
Yeah.
Very nice.
All right. Starting off strong. Look at that excited sideline. Right.
That's a front flip basket. I've never seen that in stunt.
Neither have I. It looks great, though. All right. Nice job, Scott. Great to see them hit that routine after we saw them struggle earlier.
And you may see some girls out there in gray jackets. Those are considered our spotters. So a team can have as many spotters if they want as they want out there. They just have to have a different colored shirt on and their number has to be covered.
Yeah, you see the spotters mostly in this pyramid and toss section.
Mostly in our upper level routines.
Yeah.
Scots.
Definitely makes sense. It's a good thing to have out there. All right, and the Scots are getting the point. And CMU chooses routine number five. Baskets.
Now moving to our ending formation.
Oh.
I'm gonna do a popover.
All right, Central went down on this one, but the other half looked strong.
Looks like we have a decision.
Point to the Scots. All right, routine number four is up next. Start. Oh. Small bobble from Alma there, but they're able to keep it up and strong.
When you took baskets all in a row, that's very hard to sync up.
Mm-hmm. And the point goes to the Scots. All right, Scots lead 8-1 going into the half. We'll be back in 10 minutes. All right, we are back for the second half. We are starting off with routine number seven.
Routine number eight.
Oh, eight.
This is the first time this is going to play today. And
I know, I'm very excited.
I think this is the first eight we've seen all day, actually.
Yeah. We have some very advanced skills here. That was great.
Two to falls. Wow. Layouts. Wow, very sticky feet. And another fall. Stuck. Very nice.
I mean, they are rock solid. That was great.
Now again, that was a great routine, but the Scots have to play to the standard, so we'll see how the judges go.
Yeah, Central Michigan forfeited that routine, but in the second year program with a lot smaller team than the Scots, sometimes it's hard to get those more difficult skills. All right, and the Scots do get the point. All right, Central chooses routine number two. And for Central being a second year program, they've put in routines all the way up to seven, which is very impressive. They're a team full of a lot of talent. It'll be exciting to watch them over the next few years. Again, a beautiful touch from Carly Scott. Now we just wait for the judge's decision.
Again, these lower levels, there's a lot more motions, like high V's and the walks and that seat roll that you saw. So those are also very difficult to time up, and they're a lot more mentally taxing because it's one more thing you have to remember to do.
Yeah. And it's some of those extra things that aren't even necessarily pertaining to the criteria of the rounds. You know, we're looking at jumps and tumble here, but like you said, there is a lot of motion and so a lot of coordination and synchronization that comes with that.
And if those motions are missed, those are minors. Or it could be up to a major.
All right, and Alma gets the point. All right, routine number four is what the Scots have chosen. Pretty excited sidelines from each team. Starting off with some nice tucks. Nice cartwheel tucks. All right, and Central and Alma tie for the point in that round. Central gets to choose, and they're gonna go with routine number five. back handsprings were nice.
Very nice. Stick and stand from both teams.
This is a nice routine from each team. Definitely some powerful tumblers on each team. In current news with Stunt the Sport, the Great Midwest Athletic Conference will be conducting the first college conference championship this coming April, with 8 schools sponsoring Stunt and more conferences making plans to join them in the future. This is really exciting as Stunt was recently elevated to NCAA Emerging Sport status with a Division II membership. Right. Point goes to the Scots, and we finish quarter three with Alma 12 points and CMU 2. We're going to take a 2-minute break and come back for quarter four. All right, we are back for quarter four. And quarter four is going to start with routine number four. As we get up set up for the first routine of this quarter, we'd like to thank our gold sponsors, My Michigan Health, once again. My Michigan Health is the exclusive healthcare provider for Alma College. All right, we have a solid start from Alma. Central is having some trouble. Let's see if they can come back. All right, and they're gonna get back up in the air and stick those stunts now. Cartwheel tucks. I feel like there's a lot of hurdlers in this year's routines. We've been seeing that a lot. The one jump we haven't seen, I haven't seen a pike yet.
I don't know if I have either.
I know there was some pikes last year. It's just been toe touches and hurdlers this year.
Way to keep it up, CMU.
Yeah.
They had a bobble and they were able to fix that. That was really awesome to see. Again, three tuck baskets in a row is really hard to sync up and to make sure that they're all the same height.
All right, and Central came down in that last period as they pyramid. As they were getting up, you kind of could see the foot slip off of the shoulder. So once again, there's 3 points awarded to this round. So teams are still able to beat one another or tie. You can stay connected with all of your favorite Alma teams using social media and our Alma Scots Front Row app. And point one goes to the Scots. Point two also goes to the Scots. And point three goes to the Scots. First round goes 3-0. And Central will call a timeout.
These timeouts are only a minute long, so it's really important that all the athletes are listening and the coaches know exactly what they want to say.
It'll be interesting to see which routine is chosen after this timeout time. Obviously, right now they're having a little bit extra time to discuss and get through to their teams.
Because Alma won all three routines, CMU will take possession, so it'll be their turn to call.
Right, Alma looks ready to go with about 17 seconds left in the timeout. We've been talking today, we only saw one routine eight, and that was in the jump and tumble section. We're really hoping to see a routine eight in this fourth quarter. That's the highest and hardest amount of skill. So it would be really exciting to see that routine competed today. All right, so after that timeout, Central's gonna call routine number three.
Alma also calls a timeout.
Interesting. It's interesting that a timeout was called right when they took the mat after that we just had one. And we're going into routine three, which again is on that lower level, so something the Scots probably have mastered. Just about ready to start this routine. All right, and we're sticking with number three. Okay, we got a nice start from each team. Looking solid. Each team is, that partner stunt was solid on both teams, very on time.
More side tumbling.
Yeah, the spring step out is something I haven't seen in a while.
Stick and stand from both of those round off tricks and senior side, that was amazing.
Nice solid round off springs. Classic, nicely stuck, standing tuck. All right, let's head into our pyramids. I'm gonna start with tosses. A kick pull. Strong finish from each team there. That's a good routine. We have a very lively crowd here today. We filled up a lot of these bleacher seats. You know, Central Michigan's not too far away, so we've probably got a lot of Central fans here as well, along with a lot of Alma College students and family members here. So it's exciting to see. Home opener of the season. You got a full bleacher packed to fans.
CMU is actually only about 20 minutes away from Alma, so they're pretty close teams.
All right, point one goes to Alma. Point two goes to Alma as well. And third point goes to the Scots. And they've chosen to do routine number two. One. They're doing routine one. That was my bad. Sometimes I can't quite see. The judge is a little farther away. So this is going to be full of all those real basic skills.
A lot of basic skills, but it's really technique driven. You have to make sure they have perfect technique in these, which is what makes them hard and difficult.
Yes.
And again, those ones with a tick up.
I do love a good tick up. And it is simple, but again, technique is huge.
A strong routine for both teams.
Yeah.
Great one to end the day on.
It's a lot of great talent and technique out on the mat right now. Thank you. Scots are busy these next couple weeks with their schedule. Next week they'll travel to Davenport, where they will play Michigan State University and Davenport. The following week they go to Olivet, and where they'll play Olivet and U of M. And the weekend of February 25th, we'll be back at home. We have a STUNT tournament with multiple teams. It'll be a two-day tournament, and we can't wait. All right, point one to the Scots. Point two to the Scots. And point three goes to the Scots. All right, we're doing routine seven. I'm gonna start off with that single group partner STUNT, which we did see in the first game. Nice start from both groups. Oh, each team has a little trouble. Gonna get right back up. And Central goes down again. Yeah. All right, now we're gonna enter a jump and tumble. This is the second hardest routine in all of these, so. A lot of skill.
Next one, we have two to fulls. Round off that game's been full.
Nice job. Nice full basket in the back there. All right, and both teams have a strong pyramid.
All right, baskets.
These are beautiful. We have a nice strong finish from Alma. We're now just waiting for that decision of the 3 points by the judges. As we mentioned in the first game, you can see that Alma's got some new uniforms on this season, and we also have brand new mats that we're competing on today. Those mats were donated by Michael Sherman, an alumni of Alma College, who also donated to the Sherman weight room facility and the Sherman cheer and STUNT facility. So we are very grateful for his continued support, supporting our athletic programs.
Alma's a very fortunate team. They have a lot of support from their college, and the cheer and STUNT facility was a huge part of my time here in Alma. Spent a lot of time down there, and it was amazing to have a facility that we could call our own.
Yeah, a lot of programs probably don't have as many facilities for their own teams as we do at Alma, and we're getting a brand new indoor track and field facility over by our soccer field and baseball fields that was donated by Greg Hatcher. So even more exciting developments here on campus. All right, point one to Alma. Point two to Alma. Point three goes to Alma. Alma goes 3-0 in this routine. And that also leaves our final score at Alma 24, CMU 2. Thank you for tuning in today. We will be back here in ArtSmith Arena on February 25th and 26th for the tournament. And Alma will be back in action next week at Davenport University. Thank you for tuning in today.